Over the years, millions of different substances were discovered by the scientists. You know that atom is the smallest unit of all forms of matter. Now, do you ever wonder how these atoms are arranged inside these substances? Do they contain similar or different types of atoms? Let's try to find out. You must have seen coal. Coal, we also known as carbon. So these are carbon or coal pieces. And this is a carbon atom. Now, what is the similarity between one piece of coal or carbon and one carbon atom? Let's take a small carbon piece. So we take a small carbon piece. Let's see what's inside this carbon piece. So you see, one small coal or carbon piece is made up of a number of carbon atoms. So you observe that even if we take one small piece of coal or carbon, it contains millions and millions of carbon atoms. So one small piece of coal consists of millions of similar carbon atoms. So we define an element as a pure substance. We'll see what a pure substance is. We define an element as a pure substance which consists of only one kind of atom. So you saw, in case of a small coal piece, if we see inside that piece, it is made up of similar carbon atoms. So coal is an element. It is made up of only one kind of atom. Let's look at some of the characteristics of the elements. We have a coal piece. Let's break this coal piece. So now, as we break it into smaller and smaller pieces, we still get the same coal. So we have an element. We know an element is a collection of similar atoms. An element is composed of only one kind of atoms. So this is an element composed of similar kinds of atoms. If we break this element, say we break it like this, what do you observe? It is still made up of the same atoms. So if we see this atom, it has the same physical and chemical properties as this atom. Similarly, any other atom has the same physical and chemical properties as any atom in this. So what do you observe if we further break this? Now we further break this. We observe that we get only one atom. But again, the physical and chemical properties of this atom are the same as the physical and chemical properties of this atom. So this is an element. The smallest unit of an element is an atom. At this stage, we can interchange the term atom with an element. We know the properties, the physical and chemical properties of this atom are the same as any atom over here. Since they are the same atoms, they have the same properties. So if we have only one atom, we can interchange the term atom with an element. So this is the same element as this. So when we break an element, we are getting the same element. It's just smaller. Now, we take one atom. We know an atom is the smallest unit of an element. We take a group of two atoms now. So what is happening? We had one atom, now we take two atoms. We know an element is a collection of similar atoms. So two atoms, they make an element. If we take a collection of four atoms, again, similar atoms coming together, they form an element. Similarly, if we take a bigger and bigger group, the collection of same kind of atoms gives us an element. So even if we have one, two, four, or a bigger group, we get the same element. We know at the stage when we have only one atom, we can interchange the term atom with an element, since it has the same properties, the same chemical and physical properties as any atom in this element. So when we have the collection of similar atoms, It gives us the element. So now we define what is a pure substance. This element consisting of similar atoms is known as a pure substance. Pure substance should have two properties. That is, it should be homogeneous and it should have particles of only one kind. So we have seen that the elements, they contain or they are composed of only one kind of particles. We see the same particles throughout. They are composed of the same type of atoms and hence they satisfy the second property. What is homogeneous? Homo means same. Homogeneous means having the same composition throughout. So if you look at this element, if you look at this part, this has the same composition. If you look at this part, same composition. You take any part of this element, you'll see the same composition throughout. This is because it is composed of the same kind of atoms. And hence, it has the same composition throughout. So it is both homogeneous and has particles of only one kind. And hence, such a substance is known as a pure substance. And we define an element as a pure substance containing only one kind of atoms. So an element is a pure substance because it is homogeneous and it has only one kind of particles. So an element cannot be broken down into simpler substances by any method, be it physical or chemical. When we tried to break a coal piece, however smaller we go, we still get coal. We are not able to break it down into any other substance. So however small we break an element, we cannot get any simpler substance. Let's take an example. Here we have carbon and gold. So if we look inside a carbon piece, we see the carbon atoms. If we look inside a gold ring, we see the gold atoms. So now if we try to break this coal piece, however small we break it, we'll still get the coal or the carbon atoms. And in this case, however small we break this gold ring, we will still get the gold atoms. We can never get gold by breaking coal. So this means, however small we break an element, it cannot be broken down into any simpler substance by any physical or chemical method. An element contains only one kind of atoms. No two elements contain the same kind of atoms. So as we just saw, the coal piece contains only carbon atoms. The gold ring contains only the gold atoms. So no two elements contain the same kind of atoms and one particular element contains similar kind of atoms. Now we know an element is a collection of similar atoms. So in this case, is this an element? Yes, we see the same atoms throughout. Since it is a collection of same atoms, hence this is an element. But what about this? Is this an element? We know that atom is the smallest unit of an element. But in this case, we see that two atoms are combined to form a molecule and then these molecules come together. So is this an element or not? We know at times atoms do not exist independently. They are not stable on their own, so they combine. They combine with other atoms. At times they combine with the similar kind of atoms and at times they combine with different types of atoms. So when similar atoms combine to form a molecule, in this case both the atoms are of the same type and when they form a molecule, they form a collection. So this is still an element because we know an element consists of the same kind of atoms. In this case, all the atoms are of same kind. But the only difference in this case is that the smallest stable unit is a molecule. This is the smallest stable unit and still this molecule is made up of similar atoms. So even though the smallest stable unit in this case is a molecule, it is still an element. Why? Because it is composed of the same kind of atoms. So an element can be composed of individual atoms, or it can be composed of molecules made up of the same kind of atoms. So if you look inside a silver ring, it is made up of individual silver atoms. And oxygen gas, it is made up of the oxygen molecules. So two oxygen atoms, they combine to form oxygen molecule, which we denote as O2. And then these O2 units, that is oxygen molecules, they come together to form the oxygen element. In this case, this is the smallest stable unit, but in this case, this is an element as it is composed of the same kind of atoms. Now, what do you think? Is this an element? Well, in this case, you observe two different kinds of atoms. Two different kinds of atoms, they combine to form a molecule, and these molecules form a collection. We know an element is composed of the same kind of atoms. So whenever we see two different kinds of atoms, this is not an element. An element is composed of either individual atoms or molecules made up of same atoms. Hence, this is not an element. So whenever similar kind of atoms, they combine to form a molecule, which then come together to form an element, we call that molecule as a molecule of an element. So the molecule, the same kind of atoms, when combined to form a molecule and they come together to form an element, these molecules are known as molecules of an element. Now an element exists, as we have just seen, it exists as either individual atoms or molecules made up of these similar kind of atoms. So how do we now define the elements? Elements are the substances which are homogeneous, that is, they have the same composition throughout, and they are composed of only one kind of atoms. And these two properties, any substance which is homogeneous and has the same kind of atoms, is known as a pure substance. So an element is a pure substance which is composed of the same kind of atoms.